Dr. Gumede? Hello?
Sorry. Hi, Dr. Peter. Sorry, I was trying to...
Hi, Dr. Gumede. Yes, I thought, you know, it would be inappropriate for us to not get, you know, a male perspective also to balance this equation. So if you could just maybe give us a little bit of input. I think you've heard what some of these women have had to say. And let's just get a male perspective to also round off our discussion. And thank you very much for being part of this discussion with us on Women's Day to show that, you know, gender-based violence is not just a female issue. It is both our issues as male and female.
Thank you very much, Doc. I'm really interested in the topic, and I think it's really a great initiative to come up with and look at gender-based sort of like violence, which relates to sort of like from the summer perspective, but also from the professional perspective. And I've just listened to both of your sort of like your panelists over there talking about issues that affect women in particular. It could either be, you know, issues that are related to cultural beliefs that might put women under a lot of stress, thereby sort of like promoting sort of like very stressful things. But I think it is something that is sort of like not hidden for the country and the world, that women in particular are actually at the receiving end of discrimination and violence. This happens not only in South Africa, but also in the rest of the world. And according to the stats, really disturbing stats that we've had in the country since the start of the lockdown, is that we've had a lot of an increase in the number of cases that have been reported on gender-based violence, particularly domestic violence, where sort of like males actually mistreat women. But I think that, you know, first of all, I think it was inappropriate for me to start up a discussion without wishing all the women today is the 9th, and I wish to take the opportunity to say Happy Women's Day to all of you, and that you are valuable to us, especially a man. We may think that we are tough because the society has made men to believe that they are tough, but I've observed in many ways. In my family, my mother, for instance, who raised me, was tougher than what I think I am today. And my wife in particular, who happens also to be a medical practitioner, I believe she's the most sort of like valuable person I can have on my side. Therefore, I have no sort of like doubts in my mind that women are capable beyond measure and that they have a significant role that they play in the society. But at the same breath, as we talk about women empowerment in the country and the world, we also need to teach men how to treat women and start that from the very early age of our sort of like kids at home and also in the workplace. I've seen this many times where you find women in leadership positions are being discriminated by the very same males that are there that are meant to protect them. And I think that this is something that is almost like a cultural thing within our society that we need to change. Same things, we talked about the issues around HIV, we talked about the issues around sort of like sexual abuse in the workplace. The availability of resources that are meant to dedicate services to women in particular, also in the workplace, they are actually on the short side of things. And we need to be proactive when it comes to all of these things for us to get to where we want to be. So, I mean, I've listened to the conversation, and I think you sort of like brought people that are highly experienced and people who are valuable in the profession that we're in. And that is a proof enough that really women play a very important role in our society. And I think men have to come in. They don't have to be invited. They need to invite themselves in this type of discussion and play an active role in terms of making sure that sort of like the women are being protected and are given a space to be able to sort of like, you know, participate also in the economy, but also in the profession and all the other spheres that we think they can contribute in. So thank you very much for the platform.